Friction is going to cause some rotation. It appears very simple on the face of it, but only when you start solving problems you will realize that the direction of the moment is not so simple to find out, number one. Number two, the perpendicular distance are very difficult to come by, and life is not so simple. All the forces are not going to be always in the Fy or the Fx direction. They will be at any angle. Our job is to simplify and get the right solution. So here the problem is, there is a force applied at A and you have to find out the moment of that force about point D. Using the Varignon's theorem, first of all resolve the 100 Newton force into its vertical component and the horizontal component, so that you can use all the distances, the perpendicular distances of the vertical and the horizontal components. The vertical component is going to cause a rotation about D in the clockwise direction. Similarly, the horizontal component also in the clockwise direction. But first of all, we need to find out Fx and Fy. Cos 25 is the horizontal component and sin 25 is the vertical component. The directions of the components are also given over here. When we take moments about D, what is the perpendicular distance of Fx from D? This one. If you apply Fx here, Fx into 2 is the moment caused about D. Similarly, the vertical component Fy is going to act at what distance? That is 1 plus 3 plus 1, that is 5 meters. So you have a moment due to Fx and a moment due to Fy. The perpendicular distances are 2 and 5. Here lies your moment. Both of them are going to be in the clockwise directions. The Varignon's theorem states that the entire moment F into D is given by the summation of the moments of each of the component. So our problem now, the moment about D is going to be the summation of the moment due to the horizontal component and the moment due to the vertical component, that is 392.57. What is the direction of this particular moment? Naturally, the summation is of these two. The summation of both of them being in the clockwise direction, this moment will also be in the clockwise directions. Thus, it can be noted that any finding out the moment about any point due to any inclined force is going to be simple using the Varignon's theorem, because here you can sum up the moments of the components. This is simpler than finding out the perpendicular distance and then finding out the moment. We'll see how the Varignon's theorem is much better than perpendicular distances. Once again, an angle. The angle is AB and BC. At the end, there are two forces. One is vertical, simple. The other one is inclined. In the first part, let us not use the Varignon's theorem and let us see how we can find out the moment about point A. Here, for the 20 Newton force, it is simple because the perpendicular distance between A and the 20 Newton force is how much? 3 meters. But finding out the perpendicular distance between the 12 Newton force and point A is going to be difficult because it is inclined. So you have to find out the perpendicular distance between these two points. This is going to be a tough job because you need to find out first of all AO and then add it to PO. That is going to be your perpendicular distance. We have tried to find out using, you are good at trigonometry. Your trigonometry is much more powerful than this generation. So, find out AO first of all using trigonometry. Then you get your BO, that will give you your OP. Finally, AP is equal to AO plus OP, which is 3.23 meters. 3.23 meters is the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation to the line of action of the force, and therefore your force MA is going to be the summation of these two forces, 20 into 3 plus 12 into the perpendicular distance 3.23, which is 98.78 in the anticlockwise direction. This was using perpendicular distances. Let us see how simple it is when we use the Verignon's theorem. Here is a Verignon's theorem. You still have the same set of problems, the same forces, the force of 20 Newton. Now here what we are going to do is we are going to resolve the 12 Newton force into its horizontal component and the vertical component. Using the Verignon's theorem, what will happen is the moment of 12 Newton force about point A is the same as the summation of the moment of this force plus the moment of this force. That is what we have done for here. The vertical 20 Newton force into the 3 meter perpendicular distance is taken care of. Then you have the vertical component 12 sine 30. Once again, the perpendicular distance is 3 meters. The horizontal component 12 cos 30. And the perpendicular distance is how much? As you can see over here, 2 meters. And therefore, you have a perpendicular distance of 2 meters. All of them are going to act in the same direction. So, we say that it is 98.78 in the clockwise direction. It is absolutely correct if you do not show the sign as plus or minus, but you are showing the actual direction of rotation. If you are not showing the actual direction of rotation, it is important that you show the sign. This sign, as we have already said in the beginning, we have assumed that all anticlockwise moments are positive and clockwise moments are going to be negative. If we go to the previous slide, look at the amount of calculations we had to do in order to find out the perpendicular distance. The equation for moment was very simple, but finding out the perpendicular distance is a bit tough. Using the Verignon's theorem, it is a very simple equation because there is no equation required to find out the perpendicular distance. The perpendicular distances are already available to you on the problem itself for the vertical component and for the horizontal component, and therefore your equation becomes a very simple single line equation of just the moments of each of the forces. We come to the next very important concept. Now that we have understood moments, we have seen how to find out moments using the Verignon's principle, we have seen what we mean by the direction of a moment, that is clockwise or anticlockwise. We come to the next important topic of the couple. What do we mean by couple? Once again, there is a rigid body. There are two forces acting on this body. Both these forces are parallel and they are having the same magnitude. Let us say the magnitude of each of these forces is F, but we are showing them by different names, F1 and F2. For the simple reason that both of them are in the opposite direction. Now, if we have a set of parallel forces having the same magnitude but acting in opposite directions to each other, then we have a couple on hand. This is going to form a couple. What is the effect of a couple? The couple is going to rotate the body depending on what is the axis of rotation. Let us say right now we are interested in this point A. This is the axis of rotation. Wherever you apply this couple, it is going to rotate the body. Mind well, the sum of both these forces is zero, and therefore there will not be any vertical or horizontal translation. But the moment is not zero because each of these forces is acting at a different distance from A. F1 is acting at a distance d1 and F2 is acting at a distance d2. D1 minus d2, let us say, is d. So the couple is going to have the effect of rotation, but how much? That rotation is going to be equal to m equals f into d, where f is the magnitude of any one of the forces and d is the distance between these two forces. So this is the concept of couple. The effect of the couple formed by forces will not be zero. These two forces will not move the body in the vertical or the horizontal direction, but they will rotate the body. Here is your value for the couple. Any couple will have a moment F whose value is going to be F1 into D1 minus F2 into D2. What do we mean by that? If we want to find out the moment M about A, then we have F1 into its perpendicular distance D1. Now F1 is going to rotate the body in the anticlockwise direction. F2 is going to rotate the body in the clockwise direction. So we have F1 into D1 minus F2 into D2. So finally that comes to F into D1 minus D2, because F1 and F2 are same, they are F. If we say that D1 by minus D2 is equal to D, then we have the moment of the couple M is equal to FD. The magnitude M is called the moment of the couple. The direction of the couple. The direction of the couple you will have to understand in order to find out the whether it is clockwise or anticlockwise. If you look at these two forces and look at the arrowheads, this force is going to try and rotate this body in this direction. Similarly, this force is also going to try and rotate in this direction. Therefore, the net effect of the couple is going to be what? Anticlockwise. This couple can be applied anywhere on the body. It will have the same effect and the same value. Let us look at another set of couples. They are applied at two different parts on the body. If this couple is acting over here, then this arrowhead shows that this couple is trying to rotate part A in this direction. Similarly, this is also trying to rotate in the anticlockwise direction. So you have an anticlockwise couple whose value is going to be 200 into the perpendicular distance, which is 50 mm. Same couple if we apply at any other point, say over here, it is also going to have the same effect. It is going to rotate the body in the same direction and same value. So we come to the last part of today's lecture, equivalent couples. What do we mean by equivalent couples? Let us say we have over here this couple, 200 magnitude of the force, the distance, perpendicular distance between the two forces, 100 mm. Therefore, the moment of the couple is going to be how much? 20 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm. We have another set of couples acting on the same body, but look at the magnitude. The magnitude is different. It is not 200. The magnitude here is 100, but the distance is 200. The net effect is going to be a couple in the anticlockwise direction having the value same as the previous couple, as our couple in A. Let us look at a third set. Here you have an 80 Newton force. Perpendicular distance is 250. The moment of the couple is going to be how much? 80 into 250. Again the same value, again the same direction. So we have equivalent couples. What do we mean by equivalent couples? Equivalent couples are going to be the couples which have the same magnitude and the same direction, even if the individual forces and the individual distances are different. So you have a couple A, a couple B, and a couple C, all having different values of the forces, but they are in the same direction and the same magnitude of the moment, and therefore they are called equivalent couples. We will stop over here and continue with our lecture series in the equivalent couples and more problems in the next session. Thank you very much.